Welcome back. This video is not for most people, I'll tell you right up front. It is really aimed at people with really big feet. And it's also kind of aimed at some questions that I had with my big feet as I searched around YouTube and other websites and I just couldn't find the answers. So I'm going to tell you right up front, it is about the pair of shoes that you've probably seen in a lot of hiker videos, Altras, but I'm going to take just a slightly different angle. So again, if you don't have big, huge feet, I don't know how interesting this is going to be. So if you do have big, huge feet, and I'm talking about you guys and gals out there who cannot go to a store and find shoes, that's right. So if you can just go to a store and just buy shoes, you are really, really lucky. I literally cannot leave my house and go to a store, go to a mall, go anywhere and find shoes that fit me. They just are not sold in stores. I have a size 15, quadruple E. Maybe it's somewhere like between that 3 and 4E sort of size foot. Ever since I was little, I can remember my mom holding me by the hand, bringing me into the shoe store, passing all those shoes on the rack, and I had to go into the back room and look at the catalog. So I was always the kid who had shoes that nobody else had in school, which was kind of cool. And then for a while, as I grew up, it was just a pain to find shoes. They were normally always at like some outlet. If we'd go on vacation and there were like outlets somewhere, I would always look in the outlets. And if I found a pair of shoes that fit, I would buy up, if there's two pairs, I would buy both of them. So when I started to go backpacking, it was really hard to find. I started off with boots years ago. It was so hard to find boots. With catalogs and stuff, I was sometimes able to custom order, boots. Sometimes I'd find some like sizes 13 or 14 and wide that I would squeeze into, but it was always kind of an uncomfortable thing. So when I started going more ultralight and in the last, 3 years ago or so, started getting back into kind of looking on the internet for what shoes to wear for people with big feet. And one of the brands that kept coming up were Altras. And I don't know about where you live, but nobody sells Altras where I live. There's one store that's like, 50 minutes away from me. And of course, they don't have size 15s. And if you order for them for a size 15, they charge you. They don't take it back and just exchange it if it doesn't fit. So I was really kind of, a little iffy on ordering them. And what I decided to do was to take the plunge. I got on a bunch of, I wasn't looking at backpacking sites. I was absolutely unaware that these were even a shoe that was worn by a lot of backpackers and hikers up until this past maybe fall. What I was looking at was a lot of running sites originally. And this is the first Altra that I wore. I think this is the Superior 2.0. And these were size 14. The only way that I was able to get my shoe into the size 14 was I took out everything that was on the inside. So I was literally right on whatever the bottom of the sneaker is underneath the sole. And it was a little bit tight in places, but it was absolutely the most comfortable shoe that I've ever worn in my entire life. I absolutely loved these. These are, again, I don't know if these are like going on 3 years or so. These shoes have now been put down into the order of, I don't wear these to work anymore, I don't wear these hiking, unless it's pouring out. It's like yesterday I was out and it was, the trails were like rivers, and that's when I put away my other shoes and take these out. One of the problems with Altras, and this is, you can see it all across the boards, and again, I haven't really looked at like, say, backpacking and hiking boards of people wearing these, but on people who use them for running, is where they rip. I don't know if you can see it in the video, but after yesterday I dried these out and I have hot glue guns the whole tip again so they don't fall off. The rip right there happened immediately. That was maybe more due to the fact that, again, my foot is so wide and I should have ordered the next size up. But with some hot glue, the little tongue piece here has been super glued a whole bunch of times. On this shoe here, the same thing, like the whole front end is all hot glue guns. And I would never wear these on like a long trip where I really had to rely on them. But for the day hike where, even if they do end up falling apart at the end of the day and I have to re-glue them, they're good enough and they kind of take the abuse instead of my other ones. one, if you don't know about Altras, I mean, there's reviews everywhere out there on Altras for people using them for backpacking purposes. So I'm not really going to give you the stuff that you can already find somewhere else. I will, again, just kind of direct this at people with really wide feet. What I found, and I think this is what actually happened, is shoes that I thought were fitting me, just because they were more comfortable than a regular width shoe, were not actually fitting me properly. They were just simply more comfortable, so I kind of got into my head what my foot should feel like in a shoe. And once I put these on, it was just like, it was like another world for my big old wide feet. The idea with Altras is they have a really wide toe box, and they have some pictures of, like, you know, x-rays of feet, and they show them being in regular shoes and being in Altras. And I don't know if it's just in my head, but I would swear, just like they say on their website, that my foot is actually spreading out. And, you know, every once in a while I look down at my toes and I say to myself, there was never space in between my toes before. They were all, like, crammed in, and, you know, your pinky is all tucked in and your big toe is tucked in. And now it's actually like there's space there. The other thing about these, that they warn you on the website, they warn you in a label that comes with the box, is these are zero drop, which means where your forefoot is, it's at the same height as your heel. And one of the things that does is, again, go do some research on, like, what impact heels make on your life, and what the damages that they can do to your legs, and how they just destroy your muscles and Achilles heel and stuff. So with no heel, it really strengthens all of your muscles and around your ankle. And in the box, it actually says, like, don't just go and wear them all day long, because all of a sudden muscles that have not been working for years are going to be forced to work and you're going to be hurting. Well, of course I was like, I can take it. And I wore them all day. I wore them to work, and I'm on my feet pretty much all day long moving around. And the next morning when I got out of bed, I was dragging my legs. My legs were so incredibly sore. So I could tell you for a fact that that part is true. If you're willing to deal with a lot of pain, go for it. But otherwise, don't go for it and just, like, wear them like you would a normal shoe. And again, I think I mentioned this, you might have seen it in another video. I was someone who backpacked a lot, and then I had this big old part of my life, 15 years or so, where I didn't backpack at all because of knee problems. And one of the reasons why I did end up finding this brand is not only because I was looking for shoes for wide feet, but I was looking specifically for zero drop shoes. I read a lot of stories about people with knee problems who the knee problems went away once they went to a zero drop shoe. And for me, when I started getting back into backpacking with these shoes, I kind of did four things in my life that were different to help me with my knees. So I'm not sure which one to give more, I don't know, to give more credit to. But I got to give some of the credit to the shoes. And not necessarily Altra, but just the fact that they're zero drop. Yesterday I went on a hike and I came home. I mean, it was pouring out, so it was slippery, it was muddy. I'm in the rocks and every trail was like a river. I don't have any knee pain today. And it's just like, that like blows my mind. As somebody who thought their hiking life was over, it blows my mind. And these are the shoes that I was wearing. Again, incredibly comfortable. This one, I was a little conservative and I ordered a size 14 because that's what I always thought I wore. Didn't really fit that well. Again, a lot better than regular shoes. And so when I was ready to order a new pair, I called the company and they said, don't order this one. Order a different type of Altra. And that's another complaint about the company, is that you can fit just fine in one shoe, you buy the next model, and now all of a sudden you don't fit in it. Or you buy a different model and, you know, it fits totally different. So what they recommended was the Altra Lone Peak. And both of these shoes I ordered, like, when the new model came out. So if this is 2.0, like when the 2.5 came out, obviously stores that have 2.0 online are selling them cheap. So that's when I bought these. And even same thing for the Lone Peak. I think right now it's Lone Peak 3.5. I might be wrong with that. So when those came out is when I bought these. And again, unbelievably comfortable. What I really miss is there's a lot of padding with these. It's still zero drop, but there's a lot of padding. When I'm wearing these, I love it. It's like your foot is on the trail. Like, it's almost like wearing, I have a pair of Zeros, and it's almost like, you know, it's not walking barefoot, but you're right on the trail with these shoes, and you really feel everything. With these, there's a lot more padding, and I don't know, maybe it's in my head, but I find my foot shifting a little bit more, but still incredibly comfortable. These are the size 15s, and it's like, this is the shoe I always wish I could have worn all my life. I never realized how comfortable shoes could be, because I was always squeezing my foot into something. So after buying these, the size 15, I was amazed at, I didn't have to take the insole out of these. And again, these don't have a ton of miles. What they have is a ton of days on them, because again, I wear them to work every day. These I've been wearing for about a year and a half or so. So not a ton of hiking miles on them, but just a ton of just wear. And also again, that part here on both shoes has been super glued back. I literally, maybe on my second tube of super glue, constantly gluing that back. After any kind of hike, it seems to kind of start peeling back a little bit. But again, if you have big feet, give these a shot. I think, what's that, Zappos? So if you don't want to worry about shipping and stuff, you know, Zappos you can order from and you can ship it back for free. And the other thing too is that I saw, and a lot of hikers will put in different insoles and stuff to like to make it more comfortable, to do this and that in their to their foot. And one of the ideas with the zero drop and with minimal cushioning in there is that your foot will strengthen and get stronger in all those muscles. And you know, not to go into the whole, you know, everything about foot muscles, but everything I read, everything I researched, and everything that occurred to me certainly seems true. And I think part of what's helping my knees is that my ankles, and excuse me, all of my muscles down there have become a lot stronger and a lot more flexible. And I know sometimes I'll hear people say, well, I'm going on a hike to such and such a place, and I need my hiking boots because I need more support. Well, one of the reasons why you need more support is because your ankles have become so weak. And I was a hiking boot person for up until 3 years ago or something like that, until I bought these, and then later learned this past fall that, you know, there's a whole lot of people out on the trails that are wearing these. So I can't recommend them highly enough. I hate doing something that sounds like a commercial, but if you got big, wide feet, this brand is awesome. I have looked at a lot of other brands out there, and again, just from online reviews, from videos, etc., I really couldn't commit to any of the other brands. Yes, they might have the big toe box, but none of them, you know, were kind of that guarantee to fit wide feet. Also, it's really hard to find sizes 14 and 15. So most places that carry this online, not most places, but definitely from the Altra website, you can always find a 14 and 15 if you not only have wide feet, but if you also have big feet. So again, I traditionally used to order a size 13, 14, 3E. Thought that was comfortable, and I moved up to ordering a 4E. So like New Balance is the classic company that, if you're still watching this and you're a Bigfoot person, you might have, you know, special ordered from New Balance like me a bunch of times. And you know, my last pair that was special ordered from New Balance was probably size 14 4E. So these are 15, just they don't come in widths, it's just 15. And these have been phenomenal for me. I really wish I had discovered this. I don't know how long this company's been around, but I really wish I had discovered this earlier. So again, if you were Googling what kind of shoes for people with big feet, for backpacking or whatever, and you found this video, these are trail proven. I do actually have big, huge feet. I'm just not saying they might fit. They do fit my feet. I don't know if you can see it. Can I do this? Oh, this was the pair I wore before. Those are Merrells, Merrell Moabs, I believe. Those are size 14, and they come in a wide size. And I can tell you that this is my second pair of these, and these are, gosh, I don't even know how old, 5, 6 years old. and the newer ones don't fit like this. These used to, or these did. And when I compare the Merrells versus these, there's no comparison. The Merrells are comfortable. I do actually somewhat fit into them, but it is the narrow toe box with these wide toe box. Can't go wrong with them. And these are all the old models. So go out, get the 3.5. It has a lot of additional protection, I believe, around the toe box for rocks. I think they've kind of figured out that a lot of hikers are wearing these. And I'm pretty sure I have babbled enough about sneakers. So I'll end this video here. And thanks for listening. If you are a Bigfoot person out there and you have any questions about them, please be sure to ask in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer. Because I know, again, if you're like me, it's hard to take that jump, especially if you don't have money. You know, if you have a bunch of money and putting down $100 on shoes is no big deal for you, then hey, go order an experiment. But for me, experimenting with $100, that's a big deal. And so I wish I kind of saw a video like this that would make me feel more at ease before I ordered. So, Altra, Lone Peak, these are 3.0s, the 3.5s. The Altra Superiors, again, I was told were not as wide with the newer model. All right, thank you for watching.